Hi, grade five. I'm sorry, guys. Once I end the first meeting, I have to wait for it to convert. I have to wait for the file to convert so that I'm able to upload it for you on YouTube. So if I had canceled the conversion, that would have meant that I would have lost the video. So I waited for it to convert to video format so that it's there for me to upload. I can't start a new meeting until it finishes the converting. Okay. So please, if you have a class group, please let them know that we have class. If you can.
Yeah. Told them, did anyone join the meeting? And let me tell them you can't go and join.
All right. So I'm going to share my screen. All right, can you see my screen? So we stopped on number 11.
We on generations.
Generations.
No, we said generation. Generation. We said generations.
Okay.
Next word is naturalist.
Next word is naturalist.
Page 61.
61. Miss Ty, got it.
Found it? Okay. What a magical place, Roosevelt thought, gazing around one last time. He was glad he had come to Yosemite. He felt more alive than ever. Thanks to his really good camping trip with John Muir. Once back in Washington, Roosevelt would be able to do some forest good, as the old naturalist would say. So who is the naturalist in our story? Raise your hand on the screen, guys. Zane is the only one with his hand raised. Tell me, Zane. Raise your hand.
It's easy.
Okay, Zane, what is a naturalist? And who is the naturalist in the story?
Naturalist means a person who is specialized in a study of things.
Okay, so it is a person who specializes in the study of things in nature, especially animals and plants. All right. Guys, all right, so a person who specializes in the study of things in nature, especially animals and plants. All right, is this clear, guys? Who is the naturalist in the story that we read? Who was the naturalist in Camping with the President? Do you remember? It wasn't Roosevelt. Who was it? Who was the naturalist that he traveled to meet?
John Muir.
John Muir, that's right.
John Muir.
So he is the naturalist. I said what?
I said what? And you said to me.
I didn't hear you, dear. I didn't hear you. All right. So does everybody understand what a naturalist is?
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Then your sound is
It's then muffled. Your sound there's is
something else.
And there's an echo.
All right,
let's move on to number 13.
Miss, it was John Muir.
John Muir, that's right.
Yeah, John Muir.
Number 13, here is Encounter. Encounter. I remember there was an encounter with a squirrel, right?
Yeah. 64.
Yeah.
64.
What would that say?
64. Oh, okay. So this
64.
Is this is the extension. This is not the story that we read. But the word is here on page 64. Okay.
Okay.
So it says Roosevelt decided to take a walk in the countryside with a naturalist. He wanted to see the birds in person. While on his walk, one type of bird impressed him. He wrote of this encounter in his autobiography. All right, so what is an encounter? So he had an encounter.
Yes, I know. Usually unexpected meeting.
It is what?
Unexpected
meeting. Very good.
Usually unexpected meeting.
Usually unexpected meeting. All right. All you have to remember, guys, is an unexpected meeting. Okay. All right. Is this clear?
Yeah.
Okay, number 14. Zane, I think, Zane, is that you who's speaking?
Yeah.
There's something wrong with your sound. I can't hear you.
Yeah.
Zane?
The next one is here.
Cheer. I saw
look
it.
For it in the text.
Something
yeah, 56.
Okay. Yeah, I found it. All right. Yosemite 56. Valley lay 3,000 feet directly below them. The Merced River, a curving ribbon of gray blue, flowed through the green valley floor. Rock walls, interspersed with waterfalls, ring the valley. Muir pointed out upper and lower Yosemite Falls with mist rising from below and the sheer face of Half Dome. What does
Miss I know what mean? She steep.
Steep. Very good. What is a synonym for sheer? A synonym for sheer is steep.
Steep.
Steep. Excellent. Okay. So sheer means steep.
Okay. Same page. Miss, we have spectacular.
Yes. We also have spectacular. Do you understand the meaning of sheer?
Yeah. Miss, what is steep?
It's like climbing a mountain, but you can't because it's so steep.
Excellent.
Yes. Yeah.
All right. Straight. So, it means. Straight. Do you know how? Do you know what perpendicular means?
Yes.
All right.
Yeah.
So it would be very difficult to climb something that is perpendicular. Okay. So it is. It is too straight. All right, and to occur like rising or falling in direction. Okay.
Okay.
Also, I know what like
we have
something that have end like.
It's something that, like, think of, if you want to think of something that is steep, think of a flight of stairs, all right? Think of a flight of stairs, okay? Something that is rising or falling sharply. Okay?
This?
Yes.
I cannot hear you.
I said steep means rising or falling sharply. Can you guys hear me now?
Yes.
Now
we can
hear.
Yeah. Okay. Yes. We can hear you.
Let's move
good.
On to
but
then... number 15.
15.
Spectacular.
What?
Spectacular.
Spectacular. Spectacular.
Spectacular.
It's on page 56. On the same page.
Same page?
Of sheer.
Okay.
Yeah.
His horse snorted and danced sideways along the trail. The president looked back. No one seemed to be following him. Had he truly escaped the ever-watchful eyes of his Secret Service men? Hours later, the two men arrived at Glacier Point with its spectacular views. Okay, what does spectacular mean?
Yes, I know.
Very unusual or impressive.
Very unusual or impressive.
Or impressive.
Why aren't you guys raising your hand on the screen?
We don't love raising our hand. We love entering.
You have to raise your hand so you can answer. Don't blurt out the answer. Give everyone a chance to participate.
Okay.
Very unusual and impressive.
Impressive.
I see the next word.
Okay, spectacular. Amazing.
Okay, it's
next, number 16 is, who has the list?
Yes, look.
I have the lesson.
Passionate.
Miss Passionate on page what?
I'm checking. Anybody find it?
Yes, it's yeah. Page 80. Yeah.
80? Are you sure?
Yes, yeah, 80.
The
yeah. All right, so we're moving on to the next story, right? This is a boy who invented TV.
Yeah. TV, yes. Yeah.
As he talked, he got more and more patients.
Okay, one second, guys.
Yeah, as he talked more and more.
Because I have different books. Not all of the stories are in the same book for me. Page 80. There you go. All right. So he met the two California businessmen, and over dinner one night, he took them through a step-by-step explanation of his image dissector. We all remember this because we took the story not that long ago. So these events should be fresh in your memory. A camera tube that would dissect an image into a stream of electrons, converting them into pulses of electric current. A receiver would capture the current, then convert it back to points of light. The original image. As he talked, he got more and more passionate, right? What does it mean if you are passionate about something? What does passionate mean? Where are the people who are quiet? Where is Hannah Sultan? Where is Mamdouh? Where is Yasin Sadet, Tawdei, Nurhan, Aysel, Abdurrahman? Where are you guys? Amr, you have been participating. I want someone who's not participating. Where are you guys?
I've always been participating. Right, miss?
Yasina Delaney, are you there?
Yes, he's there.
They're in the meeting.
Okay. Raise your hand if you'd like to answer. If you can tell me what passionate is. Yasina Sadet, what does passionate mean?
To have a strong feeling around something, to put all your work on it.
Okay, passionate. If you are passionate about something, you have or you show strong feelings about it. Okay, yeah. So passionate means having or showing strong feelings about something. All right. Is this similar to the definition you have in your textbooks?
Yeah, it's exactly.
What is your definition?
Miss, we have having or showing.
Having or showing strong feeling.
Okay, so the same.
Next word is
number 17.
Yeah, claim.
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 Yes. He's 72. Claim.
72.
Page 72.
Got it.
72.
Yeah, me too. All right. And up in the attic was another welcome surprise. A shelf of old popular science magazines with thrilling articles about magnetism, electricity, and those new magic boxes, radios. Philo promptly claimed this as his bedroom. Okay, so what does it mean when we claim something? What does claimed mean? Reem, can you tell me? What does claimed mean? It says you're raising your hand. Are you there?
I guess she's bringing something.
Maybe. Okay. Anybody else?
I can tell you.
Okay, Shlok, I don't think you answered, right? Shlok's been helping me with the topics.
Yeah, Shlok didn't answer that.
Declared as someone's own.
Okay, declared as someone's own. Excellent. Declared
as owned one. One own. Declared as one's own.
As one's own. All right, so.
Miss, do we have devices?
Do we have devices? Let me check.
Yeah, we have devices.
Yes, devices is the next word. All right, does everybody understand claimed? Devices.
Kilo went on investigating
television. An article called Pictures That Fly Through the Air stimulated him. Scientists were having no luck. So far, their ideas resulted in crude mechanical devices that used whirling discs and mirrors. What are devices? Who can tell me? Reem, are you there now?
Yes, I know.
Reem?
Yeah.
What does devices mean? You're raising your hand, right?
I was raising my hand because I want number 11.
Number 11. We're on number 18 now.
Hashem didn't say. Okay. Hashem.
Miss Hannah, the people did not answer.
Sure, Hannah Sultan. Go ahead. All right. I'm calling on those who are raising their hands, guys. Raise your hands.
Devices mean if the... Miss, I have to get it from the book.
It doesn't have to be the exact definition from the book. You can tell me what it means.
Yeah, it means like electronics, like mobile phones and other things.
Okay, very good. So they are
things that are made.
This is the definition in your book, I think. Things that are made or invented for
a particular purpose.
For a specific purpose. Okay, so what were mobile phones created for?
For people to be able to communicate,
to send emails, to answer phone calls, to send messages, to take photos even, okay? So this is all to connect with other people. Excellent, to be able to connect and communicate with others. Excellent. So this is the definition of devices. A device is a thing that is made or invented for a specific purpose. All right. What was the air conditioner created for? What was the air conditioner made for?
To
cool the air in hot weather. Okay. So every device has a specific purpose, a specific reason why it was made or invented. Okay, we move on to number 20.
Envisioned.
This is number 20, right? 19.
19,
envisioned, okay.
I know.
Number 19, envisioned. You find it in the text? I found it. Page 78, guys. Page 78, it's highlighted in yellow. His teacher was boggled. Philo ripped a page out of the notebook he always kept in his shirt pocket. He scribbled a diagram of an all-electric camera, the kind of converter he envisioned. An image dissector, he called it. Mr. Tolman pointed out that it would take a lot of money to build such a thing. Okay. Envisioned. What does envisioned mean?
I know.
Who's saying I know?
Like when you have something in the future.
Okay. So when you envision something, you imagine what will happen in
the future.
The future. Okay.
I'm so Oday. Miss, I'm Oday.
Okay, Oday.
This is my voice echoing.
Yes, I think Zane is the one with the echoing connection. All right, so what is the definition you guys have in your textbook? Is it the same?
I know. Imagine something that could happen.
That could or would happen in the future.
Imagine what?
Imagine something that could happen
or would
in the future.
Or would happen in the future.
Okay. Could or would happen in
patents.
All right, but in class, guys, I told you that patents is the British pronunciation. In English, it is patent. Okay, patent.
Okay. Yeah, got it. On page 81.
Page 81. Let's see. All right. Philo hit upon a way to work 24 hours a day. He set himself problems to solve while sleeping. He filed for several government patents that would protect his ideas for the next 17 years. It was important to him to keep control, to get credit. All right, so what are patents?
Miss, I know.
Patents is papers issued.
We discussed, guys, in class that they are important to apply for these so that people do not steal your idea.
Miss, the meaning, the definition is
issued
to a person.
Okay, guys, raise your hand. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Amra, have you, did you answer? Go ahead, Amra, tell me what is it.
Paper issued to a person.
Or company.
Or a company.
Or company. By the government.
By the government.
Okay. That grant the knife.
Are papers, I'll write the definition here for you. Papers that give a person.
No, that's not the definition.
It's the definition. It's more or less the same. I'll give you my definition and you tell me yours, all right?
Or a company by the government. Or
company.
Or a company by the government.
Hang on, guys. The right to use, use, or sell new inventions
for a certain
number of years, all right, or for a period of time.
Okay.
All right. It is the same meaning.
It's the same meaning, right? Maybe it's worded differently, but it's the same meaning. So patents are papers that you apply for, all right? You apply for this, and it gives a person or a company the right to make, use, or sell new inventions for a period of time. Okay?
Yes.
All right, guys, let's move on to number 21. What is 21?
Okay. Drawbacks.
Drawbacks.
What?
What are drawbacks? 21, here we are on.
93. Miss, what is drawbacks?
Drawbacks, we're going to discuss it now. Let's find it in the text. It's in our persuasive article.
Yeah, found it.
Things that make something more difficult or unpleasant.
All right, here, let's see. So on page 93, this is about public transportation, all right? And the author is listing all of the great things that come with a public transportation, how it's less oil, it's better for the environment, and there are new high-speed trains.
I say it.
That have many pros, so there are many good things about it, but there are also some drawbacks, and drawbacks are cons or disadvantages, all right, so negative effects. So let's see, a few drawbacks could derail high-speed trains in the United States. Opponents cite their costs. So cost is one of the drawbacks, one of the disadvantages. Safety is also a concern. It's not very safe. This is another drawback. So what are drawbacks, guys?
Something that makes something more difficult or
unpleasant.
All right, something that makes something more difficult. Okay, here, I'll make it easier for you. Drawbacks are problems or disadvantages.
I wrote disadvantages only.
Okay, drawbacks are problems or disadvantages. Okay? So we can talk about, do you guys know the N95 masks? Okay, so there are many great things about this mask that it is safe. The N95 mask.
Ms. Hanan, I have one.
So one of the drawbacks of this mask is that it is difficult to breathe in, for example. Okay, so it's very safe and there are many good things about it, but one of the drawbacks is that it's difficult to breathe while you are wearing the mask. One of the disadvantages is that, okay?
Miss, this mask was like the crow face?
No, it's round. It's round and it's typically white, and the string is, the elastic is like yellow.
I make my face hurt too much.
It's very tight.
It's too hard.
All right, so the drawbacks are that it's tight, it's very hot. All right, so let's go ahead and finish before we run out of time.
Not that much time because I want us to look at personal narratives. No, we have 10 minutes.
Okay. What's number 22?
Data. In page 90.
91. Okay. All right. Of course, public transportation has its good points. It uses less fuel per person than a car. But over the years, cars have become more fuel efficient. To cite government data, in 1975, cars averaged 13.1 miles per gallon. In 2009, average miles per gallon had risen to 21.1. So these are what is being listed here. This is information. Okay, so data is what? Facts, figures, and other important information. Okay. So data, facts, figures, and other kinds. If you would like to, this should be similar to the definition in your textbook, okay?
Yes.
All right, also guys, the video will be on Smart Schools if you need help finding the meaning of a word, okay? Number 23, is this clear guys, data is clear?
Yeah.
Okay, number
23.
What is number 23?
Analysis.
Page 91. Got it. Okay. All right. The cars have radar, laser scanners, and video cameras. These devices keep the car on the road, avoid other cars, and stay within the speed limit. A computer is able to access information from sensors in the car and make an instant analysis of the situation. What is an analysis? Who knows? Raise your hand, guys, on the screen. Habiba, do you know? What is an analysis?
A careful experimentation and study of something.
Right, a careful examination or study of something. All right, so it comes from the verb analyze, to carefully look at something or study something. Who said Miss Waite?
Yeah, miss. Wait, miss.
Are you writing the definition?
Yeah.
Okay.
The next word is access.
The next word is access. Okay, are you done, Reem?
Same read, same paragraph.
It is the in the same
read the definition.
Okay, dear. 24, right? Or 25, I think 24? Yeah. Okay, access.
24, access. It's on the same page, 91.
Yeah.
91.
Okay. Access, okay. So a computer is able to access information from sensors in the car and make an instant analysis of the situation. What does access mean? Access, if you access information, this means that you get it from a source,
To get into something.
All right. So to access, okay, means to get into something. All right. What definition do you guys have in your books?
Get at or into something.
Get at?
Get in or into.
Get in, yeah.
In or into something.
Oh, it's at, not in.
I think in would make more sense. Who has their literature anthology? Look at the back of the book. Look for access. What is the definition? To get in or into something?
To get at or into something.
At. Okay. All right, to get at or into something. All right, to help you guys remember, to get something from a source. Okay, for example, if you want to access information about the new iPhone, you can access information from the internet, for example. Okay. All right. Is access clear? To get at or into something. Number 25.
Reasoning.
Reasoning. Where is reasoning in the text?
Same page 91.
Same page
91.
All right. What is the reasoning behind building these automatic cars? Safety is a major goal. What does reasoning mean?
I know.
Okay, Shlok, tell me.
Sensible thinking.
Very good. Okay, so it's logical, also logical thinking.
The process of drawing conclusions from facts and the sensible.
Again, Duini, can you tell me from the beginning? What is it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Drawing conclusions from facts, clear and sensible thinking.
Okay, excellent. Let me try to make this definition a little bit easier for you. Reasoning means having the ability to think in a logical way. What is a logical way? A way that makes sense. Okay, so we use logic. All right, having the ability to think in a logical way. Okay? So these are your vocabulary words. I don't think they're that difficult.
Yeah,
right? Only 25. This video will be uploaded on Smart Schools, yes? Okay?
It's easy.
I wanted to show you guys something quickly. Which folder? In week four, in your week four folder, on I believe it was Wednesday, Wednesday, here we have a video about personal narratives. All right, so on in week four, the video for Wednesday was about personal narratives. I would like, after the meeting or anytime today, when you guys are free, to watch this part about personal narratives. I believe it begins from minute 5. All right. You can also find this in your language arts textbook. Okay, I said from minute 5. All right, so from 5, yes, week 4, the Wednesday video. All right, because tomorrow in class, for those of you who are physical students, we are going to be writing our personal narrative. Okay, this is going to be your term project. We'll take one session, right? So a simple project we're going to do together in class. For those of you who are online students, it will be posted for you and you will complete it and send it to me. We're going to complete a sequence chart similar to the one that we did in class. Remember how we talked about going back to school in the time of Corona, and we made a big sequence chart on the board. We're going to be doing a similar chart. All right, so in class, you are going to make a similar chart, and then you're going to draft your writing, proofread it, and rewrite it for me. Okay, and this will be your project. I will upload the project sheet for everyone to have a look at it. Again, guys, only those who are online students are allowed to do it from home. If you are a physical student, you must attend tomorrow. You must come to school and complete it in class with us.
Right. The one was physical and online. Sometimes he be online, sometimes he be physical.
My understanding is that if you are a physical student, then you have to, sorry, if you are an online student, you must inform the administration and you are no longer considered a physical student. All right, so if you are physical, if you are registered as physical students, those of you who come to school every day, I know those of you who come to school, and those of you who I have not seen since the beginning of the year, for example, the online students, those of you that are registered as online, please, you are allowed to complete it at home and send it to me, all right? Send it to me by email. Again, guys, I will be available for questions. If you have any questions at all, let me know. But I just want for you to read about personal narratives, refresh your memory before we do them in class tomorrow.
I have a question now.
Watching yes, video.
Will we do our project in our journal or any paper?
Please bring your journal to class tomorrow. Bring your journal in class tomorrow. Okay. And I'm going to give you time during the session. It's going to be like a workshop. We're going to all write together and I will be there to help you with questions. For those of you who are at home, if you have any questions after I post the project sheet, also please let me know, send me a message and I'll be happy to help you. Okay? Have another question, Stoke?
Will it be our old
journal? I asked you for two notebooks, right? At the beginning of the year, in the project sheet. Did I ask you for one or two?
Two.
Two, okay. So one of them, the one that you do not write in every day, the one that you have not touched yet, the journal, this is what I would like for you to bring to class.
Okay.
Okay, but also bring your regular notebook because after we finish the project, we're going to continue review. All right, we're going to review the genres. Did you guys see this? Did you guys see the video?
Yes.
Did you see it before?
Yes.
Or just now?
No, I see it before.
Just now.
Okay. I thought that this whole time my screen was shared. I thought you could see like me. That's why I was telling you minute number 5. And okay, so here it is on Smart Schools.
Miss, the meeting will end in
exactly 2 minutes. All right, so here on Smart Schools, who wants to say something? No, dear, your voice is not clear at all, Zane. There's something wrong with your connection. Okay, Yassine's hand is raised. Yassine, do you have a question? Raise your voice. I can't hear you, dear.
No, I don't have.
You don't have. Okay, I'm good. Question?
No.
No? All right. So the meeting will shut off now, guys. Check the Wednesday video. If you'd like to just read about personal narratives in your language arts textbook, that's fine also. I don't have the book with me right now, but it's at the end of Unit 1. Yeah. All right. So if you'd like to look at the steps are pre-write, then draft. Then what comes next? Pre-write, draft, revise, proofread, and then publish. Okay, so there are 5 steps. Look at them and just refresh your memory before tomorrow. If you have any other questions, please feel free to let me know. Okay, I will see you all tomorrow. And those of you who are at home, I will send you a video. Bye-bye, guys.
Bye.
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 See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, dear. Bye.